Philip Sims in person, in practice, to evaluate him. What will you be looking for today from him, and will you be paying a little extra attention to him today?
Oh, well, from all of our quarterbacks, you always look for the ability to throw the ball where they need to throw it. You know, nobody wants to see Philip throw, but that's part of the evaluation of the quarterback's accuracy. Getting the ball to the receivers, or the playmakers that we need to get the ball to. So, you know, not just watching him, but watching, you know, Michael's progress, David's progress. You know, it's one day, so, you know, don't put everything into just one day worth of evaluations. But we're looking forward to, you know, the process here, you know, this week of practice and how much guys can retain, pick up, and execute once we get out on the field.
Talk about how excited you are to finally put boots on the ground and, well, not pads on, but just start practicing again.
Well, you know, it's a great feeling in that, as I said before, the teams have opportunities to play in bowl games. You know, this cycle around is not that far away. And I love the game. The players want to be competitive. They want a chance to win. And now the season here, it just seems like not too long ago we finished with the bowl game and spring practice that, you know, we're back in the football mode again. So, you know, for the next 3 weeks, you know, we'll just concentrate on football. And then when school starts, you know, we'll go back to being a, you know, being a student. But right now, I think everybody's excited about finding out, you know, where we are, how far we've come, and how much further we need to go.
Are there one or two things on the checklist you're trying to accomplish in the first few days here?
Recall, you know, from what we were doing from our scheme and systems. And then, you know, Evan Marcus has done a great job in terms of their physical conditioning, their strength levels. And you get an opportunity to see that right now. So, you know, what they recall from what we've done, and then how much faster we are, how much stronger we are, more athletic, you know, things like that, that has a direct bearing on your strength and conditioning coach.
Mike, about adding Jonathan Lewis as a graduate assistant? I checked, he has no maroon on. So just talk about, I mean, it's a situation where those jobs are valuable. It doesn't matter where you come from. Just talk about adding him as a graduate assistant.
Yeah, you know, with the first of all, the Lewis family. I know the Lewis family very well. I hired Jonathan's brother, Kevin, when I was at the University of Richmond. And Kevin was with me for 2 years. Had a chance to recruit Jonathan, when I was at Virginia. But, you know, we were running a 3-4 scheme, 2-gap scheme, and, you know, he wasn't interested in the 2-gap and decided that, you know, going somewhere else. So I know the Lewis family well. And I know Jonathan, you know, really relishes this opportunity to become a coach, to learn from, you know, I think I got some great coaches on this staff. And I like to tell everybody that Jonathan right now leads on to blue. I know he's a Legion's guy. So, you know, he's got some kidding, you know, behind all that. You know, people have called in, what are you doing? I can't believe it. You know, like I said, I know the family well. And the Lewis family is a great family. And I think Jonathan would be a great addition for us.